In this episode, we are going to focus on the electrochemical background of galvanic cells. We are going to discuss what kind of chemical reactions happen in a Daniell cell and what are the basic parts of it. And of course, all of this in under 5 minutes. Galvanic, or voltaic cells are electrochemical devices, which generates electricity from spontaneous oxidation-reduction reactions. So let's talk about the basic structure of a voltaic cell, illustrated by the most common example, which is the Daniell cell. It is composed of two half cells, connected by a salt bridge. In the case of metal electrodes, a half cell composed of a solid metal and an electrolyte, which is a sodium filled with the cations of the metal. In this case, it is zinc, submerged in zinc sulfate solution, and copper, submerged in copper sulfate solution. As we put these pieces of the galvanic cell together, electrons start flowing from the negative part to the positive, which we call electricity, and can turn on a light bulb, or we can measure it with a voltmeter. Now let's see what is happening in the electrolytes. As zinc atoms lose 2 electrons, they become zinc 2 plus ions and dissolve in the water. This is the oxidation process, and the half cell where it takes place is the anode. In the other beaker, Cu2 plus ions gain the electrons of the zinc and become copper atoms. This half reaction is a reduction reaction, and this half cell is called cathode. As the reaction goes on, the cathode gets bigger and bigger as it gets more copper ions. The anode gets smaller as it loses electrons, and hence atoms as well. So if you watch closely, you can notice that there are positive ions accumulated on the left side and negative ions on the right side. If there were no ion bridge, one half cell would gather the positive ions together, and the other one would gather the negative ions, thus preventing further reactions. Fortunately, we do have a salt bridge, which is usually a U-shaped glass tube filled with an electrolyte. This electrolyte can be constructed from several components, but it is always composed of positive and negative ions. In the case of our Daniell cell, it can be composed of potassium and nitrate ions, for example. The positive ions migrate into the solution, where the negative ions are accumulated, and the negative ions migrate into the solution where the positive ions are located. If you like this video, please support my work by subscribing to my channel, so I can make more of it in the future.